Now, during lockdown, a lot of us spent more time on screens. Our children had plenty more of it too, both recreational and online learning. But what happens when your child comes across something they shouldn't be watching? How do you have that conversation with your kids if they find adult content?
The Department of Internal Affairs has started a campaign to help Kiwi families navigate the online world. And we've partnered with them to bring some important messages to you.
Keep it real online. It's a campaign targeted at parents with kids who are active in cyberspace.
We're here because your son just looked us up online, you know, to watch us.
Matt! Matt, darling, there's some people here to see you!
One in four young people first saw adult content by the age of 12. Most of them weren't even seeking it out, but they came across it anyway.
Hey, Maddie! You're right?
Okay, Sandra, stay calm. You know what to do here.
All right, Maddie. It sounds like it's time to have a talk about the difference between what you see online and real-life relationships.
So how do parents have that most delicate of talks?
And Chief Censor David Shanks is here. Good to talk to you, David. Now, families all have their own rules in the real world. How do we get those to translate to the online world?
Well, increasingly, parenting is just as much about parenting in the digital world as it is about parenting in the real world. And just as you wouldn't want to send your child out into a busy street on their bike without teaching them the road rules and making sure that they had a helmet, there are things that parents can do in an equivalent way to keep their child safe in the digital world.
What can parents do to help protect their kids from adult content online?
Well, for younger kids, it's often a matter of reasonable supervision, keeping them in kid-friendly zones, and also parental controls can be really helpful. For older kids, when they get into their teenage years, it's more about having good conversations with them and making sure that they know that they can come to you for guidance and help.
Can you give us some tips on how to have those tricky conversations with your children? Because they are tricky. How do you bring it up?
Look, these can be difficult conversations, but one way to approach it is by starting early. Having conversations often as your child is growing up in age-appropriate ways and engaging with them about what they're viewing and making sure that they know that you're there for them. I think there's plenty of guidance for parents to engage with these difficult but important conversations on the website.
Thank you so much for the advice, David. Good to talk to you.
Thank you.
And the thing about these sorts of conversations are they're new conversations between parents and children. These conversations didn't take place 20 years ago. They didn't take place 30 years ago. So they're new conversations that you haven't watched your parents have with you, so you don't necessarily know what to say, do you?
Well, the other thing, you think 50 years ago, nobody was having conversations about anything.
No.
Lucky parents. Now we have to have all these really difficult conversations. Can I recommend long car trips where nobody right. can escape from each other? Anyway, if you're about to have one of those conversations, you can find tips to help you get started at keepitrealonline.govt.nz.